Thank you, ma'am. I saw how wrong. Everyone who wrote there in the village was seen in the first act in the village. And we still not do it. Never meant to lower God, theater, the higher activity in there. How you do so, did it? I'm not mad at you. And the mill was not only all their table, have to go down low, but dishes, brought on spoon, and then food, and kept frost, and had no heat. But as good men, when they have to do it as possible, that's how they do it. And then finally came this, say to you, great food to all the people who do produce these dinners year after year. Say to you, you probably know, we've kept that for the government, even though people say that we have lived a better ice cream life on our hilltops. Now, what do I have to thank you for? This year, of course, we all know, great things we have to thank you for at the end of the war. We here in Putney, particularly, were very fortunate. Among our students, in a great number, that fought in the surgery. We only, as far as I know, had 3 wounded and 3 killed. We feel very sad that those 3 can't ever be with us again. But we also feel that had the war gone on, that number was gone too long. But aside from that sadness, and I don't think that we have too much to be grateful thankful for when we think of the world, because it still lies in turmoil around us. And I feel that each one of us, as we take this today, should dedicate ourselves not to a fight with weapons of war, but to a fight to teach our lessons, to make our peace that we've so busy talked about come true. That is, we said freedom from fear, freedom from want, freedom from intolerance. And it's in words, very pretty words, but they haven't gone much further. And I feel that we tell every one in the whole world, that's the very big thing that I said before, man can't accomplish the impossible. Has as much as we can be, and so